my friends. How are you doing this great Wednesday early afternoon? It's about 12:37 here in Georgia. Today, been battling that. Got the camera tilted back a little bit further, so hopefully the view is better. Looks like our Saturday ride to Greenville had no helmet cam on the way up there. That I didn't have any helmet cam video because I knew I wasn't going to do audio because I was using my open face helmet. I didn't figure it would be very good to start with, so I had already planned not to have video or audio. Come to find out it didn't even run, it shut off almost immediately. They'll quit getting that error. And I'm guessing that I must have had that other card in it. But it's the way it goes. Lost, but I just don't two front cameras that had a microphone you could hook up, but my Apeman doesn't have a microphone. Now I'm very paying attention to my speed out here for GSP nabs me. I don't know they're out here much anymore. Their primary responsibility is Highway 53 and more so Highway 347, better known as Friendship Road. But I took my cup holder off since I don't use it very much with this full face helmet. Put it in my touring pack so it's there if I need it. I just gotta get another rubber grommet. That one fell apart, but I'd had a couple comments about it would look better without that cup holder covering half the thing, so we're going to see how that does. 90% of the time when I'm using this modular helmet, the cup holder doesn't really come into play too much. Thing I discovered with the modular helmet was like, okay, I can't drink nothing. Yeah, you can lift it up pretty easy. But if you're vlogging, getting everything situated back down when you close it is not the easiest thing to get the Harley mic and my vlog mic. Because of the chin curve, gotta play with the Harley mic and make sure that it's in there right. I think that's what happens to me sometimes when I get more distortion, is that chin curve was not, it's been pushed aside a little bit by the Harley mic, and allows for wind turbulence to get up in there and make noise. It is nice just to, like Saturday, just rode up there, had my music on, wasn't worried about too much, wasn't talking, just riding, enjoying. But I do enjoy the vlogging part, or the filming part. Still trying to figure out the actual vlog or the talking to you part. Only got 13 subs, I believe it's what I saw last night. So. Ain't grown that much yet. Y'all spread the word for me. See if you can get your subscribers to check out my channel. Like to see it grow a little. At this rate, it's kind of almost spinning my wheels. Throw my ferret wings back out. It's a little chilly at 61 degrees and breezy. Sort of overcast. I thought it was supposed to rain today, but it didn't really look like there was. It's just kind of an overcasty day now. And I'm so used to the last couple days that I stepped out without my mesh jacket. I was like, it's a little cooler than I'm thinking. Jacket. Took off my orange vest, put it on, and put the orange vest back on. It was like, then I'm thinking, it's almost cool enough to either went to my black mesh that's not me off the Mo Pickle. Darn weather is something else here lately. If you don't like it, just wait for the next day and you'll get something different. They always say about Georgia, if you don't like the weather, hang on, the next day it'll be different. And that's the truth. But this winter into spring has been unusual for Georgia, because we almost had to look and make sure I'm still living in Georgia. It reminds me so much of Oklahoma, where it's windy all the time. If I wanted that wind all the time, I would remain living there. Now that I think about it, I probably should have drove the truck. Wasn't thinking real hard other than, look, there's no rain, I can ride the bike, yay! I thought about it while I was mowing grass yesterday. I was thinking I would go get some corn fill the feeder this weekend. Haven't been happy with me. Now here's the stop signs they were talking about. These used to not be here. They're just throwing stop signs all over the place around here. Yeah, sort of toward the deer season. And I usually keep the feeder on her property feed in it, because I don't hunt right there, right across the street. So I usually keep it filled, but I don't know, sometime November, early December, I wasn't hunting at all, I just sort of stopped. So I'm sure my deer are not happy not having food readily available out for them. Oh, I'm sorry, boys and girls. Drone with me until I realized how much wind there was out here. I was like, well, that's fruitless. Definitely can't fly it today. Alrighty, people, we are almost to the gym, so we're going to say goodbye until I get out. And, catch you in a little bit. See ya.